Welcome back to the Michigan Geological Survey YouTube channel. The following video will discuss a variety of jobs in the geosciences, including educational needs, salaries, and the typical duties of that job. The average pay and job growth were researched using the U.S. Bureau of Labor Statistics. We have grouped jobs into five categories: environmental, natural resources, academic research, engineering, and remote sensing. This list is by no means comprehensive, but we have included them in the description below, and we hope it will be a solid beginning towards answering the age-old question, what do geoscientists do?
Careers in environmental sciences can vary greatly, from fieldwork careers to working in policy, all the way to education. Careers often involve identifying issues in environmental regulation, energy use, ecosystem health, and recommending solutions in these areas. Additional subjects such as climatology, biology, aqueous chemistry, policy, and remediation can all be included when working in an environmental career.
For students who like to get out in the field and don't mind a bit of physical work, an environmental field technician is a great starting point. At this job, you can expect to collect air, water, and soil samples for pollutant assessment, prepare and clean equipment for data collection, and discuss results and write reports for clients or project managers. Many are also responsible for site upkeep, including making sure the job site is clean and clear, necessary equipment is properly operated and maintained, and ensuring site safety. These jobs often cross over into natural resource management, and techs can be found working on many field-oriented projects in both branches. Entry-level environmental field techs had a median salary of around $47,000 in 2021. This job typically requires a bachelor's degree in earth science-related programs, but some employers will accept entry-level candidates with only a high school education depending on their duties. On top of that, most of these positions require a HAZWOP certification. Obtaining one of these prior to your search will make you a much more desirable candidate. And lastly, this job is experiencing an above-average growth expectation of around 11% by the year 2030.
Students who like to get outside and work with the earth will likely find soil science careers appealing. Soil science careers range anywhere from looking at quality or efficiency of crop production to studying the formation of soils. Careers in soil science may be of interest to you if you want to work with soil and water quality, agriculture, wetlands, or conservation. Careers in this field often involve working in laboratories and doing field work, but may involve some office work as well. Quite frequently, soil science careers may also be found in the natural resources field. Median pay for soil scientists is $74,000 per year. Typical entry-level careers require a bachelor's degree, and careers in this field are projected to grow by 9% by 2030, which is about average.
Glacial geology is the study of the physical properties and movement of ice sheets and glaciers. A glaciologist's goal is to find out whether ice sheets are growing or shrinking to learn about global sea level and climate changes. The education required is generally a bachelor's degree in geology. However, employment as a field researcher requires a master's or doctoral degree in glaciology. The average yearly income is $75,000, and the jobs are increasing at 8%.
Environmental careers often have overlap with careers in all of the other fields. Many jobs that are typical of what we think of as geology often fall into this field and may involve working for government or in the private sector.
The goal of jobs under the natural resources branch is to explore, monitor, and extract natural resources we use to keep society afloat. This includes mining, oil and gas operations, water management, food, and forest products. Students with skills in hydrology, petrophysics, mineralogy, and forest management can often secure themselves on this branch with an interesting job that takes them into the heart of how the natural world supports us.
A petroleum geologist studies the composition, structure, and other physical attributes of the earth, including rocks and minerals, exploring for gas, oil, and groundwater. The duty of a petroleum geologist is to discover the amount and the location of useful fuel, like oil and natural gas, in sediments or reservoirs. Geologists may be hired by engineering or environmental consulting firms, also by oil, gas, and mining companies, the federal and state government agencies, and even science centers and museums. Many of these jobs require an associate's degree or greater and will pay, on average, $50,000 per year with 9% job growth.
One unique career path geology students may be interested in is becoming a gemologist. Gemstones and other crystals are an important part of industry, technology, fashion, and even the medical sector. As a gemologist, you can analyze both raw and refined samples to determine their type, quality, and value. These jobs can be found in both the field and lab. Most time is devoted to the latter for easy access to their hyper-accurate instruments, including microscopes, calipers, reflectometers, and spectroscopes. Because of the wide range of uses for gemstones, there is plenty of room for interdisciplinary cooperation in engineering. Gemologists generally make around $54,000 per year. Getting started in this field may only require obtaining a certification through some trade classes. But for those looking to take their career further, there are both undergrad and graduate level courses at many colleges and universities. This is a relatively stable pathway expected to not see much change in job availability over the next decade.
Environmental protection careers can involve monitoring the environment and determining sources of contamination, as well as protecting and managing quality of natural resources, ranging from parks, beaches, wetlands, forests, and other natural resources. If you are interested in environmental protection and conservation, careers in this field may be appealing. These types of careers often involve office or laboratory work, but may include some field work depending on the level of the position hired in for. Similar jobs may also be found in both the environmental and engineering fields. Median pay for conservation scientists is $64,000 per year, and typical entry-level jobs require a bachelor's degree. Careers in this field are projected to grow by 7% by 2030, which is about average.
Again, this is just a brief overview of some of the cool jobs to be found within the natural resources sector. Like all the others, they couldn't properly function without the support of all the other branches in one way or another. Students interested in natural resources have a great opportunity to help utilize and conserve the resources that are vital to us and the many ecosystems that depend on them.
There are also jobs in the academic and research fields as well, most of which require a master's degree or greater to fulfill the tasks and responsibilities of the job.
Career focus in post-secondary education varies depending on what classes are available to teach. Typically, professors will be teaching classes similar to the field that they focused on in graduate school, but may be asked to teach entry-level courses. Work environments are typically at public or private colleges and universities, and jobs can be part-time if hired as an adjunct, but many of these positions are full-time. Many post-secondary educators may also have overlapping work in environmental, natural resources, remote sensing, and engineering fields. Median pay for post-secondary teaching is $80,000 per year. Typical entry-level jobs require a master's for two-year colleges or a PhD for four-year universities. Careers in this field are expected to grow by 12% by 2030, which is above average.
There are even geosciences jobs that are out of this world. A planetary geologist is someone who studies how other planets and the moons and the asteroids and comets and whatever else is floating out there form and evolve over time. We use what we have learned about how the Earth works to try to understand how planetary bodies work. Planetary geologists may focus on mapping out the topography of a planet, extrapolating information from asteroid core samples, or even operate the movements of a robotic exploration mission. NASA's Mars rovers have provided an amazing example of planetary geology in action, with scientists working to investigate the surface of that planet for notable geophysical evidence, especially signs of life. The median income for this job is $83,000 per year, and there is a job growth of 7%.
History comes in all shapes and forms, from the philosophers of ancient Greece to the development of supersonic jets. Geology and environmental science students can help preserve history and cultivate curiosity by becoming a natural history or natural science museum curator. Many organizations assign their curators a variety of different duties, but in many cases, this job entails acquiring and authenticating specimens. This includes securing funds, overseeing proper transportation, and making sure the subsequent preservation protocols are in effect. With that done, many curators design and monitor exhibits for the museum to make sure events are well coordinated and guests are happy. This job is a great opportunity to preserve the past wonders of the world while educating upcoming generations about how great it is. The median salary for people in these positions is about $50,000 per year. Getting a job as a museum curator often only requires a bachelor's degree as a minimum, but many organizations seek out experts in their field with many years of experience and at least a master's degree. This field is also on the rise, with a 6% predicted job growth rate over the next few years.
All of the different ways that academic research and education can take your job path can almost be mind-boggling. Fortunately, you can tailor your education to fit to what you want to do as a career.
Engineering careers focus on the use of both environmental science and technology. Careers often involve developing better methods to understand infrastructure, pollution control, natural resources, public health, and other environmental problems in relation to humans. Anywhere from building infrastructure to better withstand earthquakes to developing new computer programs used in other sections of environmental sciences. These jobs often require perspective of other areas, including atmospheric sciences, oceanography, hydrology, ecology, and biogeochemistry.
Environmental engineers serve an important role in the engineering branch because they focus on how to integrate our technology with nature to both remediate and create a more sustainable way of life. Like many jobs, people with this field in mind often specialize even further into areas like coastal management, ecology, and geophysics. In a broad sense, environmental engineers work on projects to improve recycling, waste disposal, public health, and control of water, air, and land pollution. This job most strongly crosses with environmental and natural resource branches due to its focus on cleaning up and improving the sustainability of practices like mining and freshwater diversion. If you're looking to apply your engineering skills to your passion for keeping the planet healthy, this can be a great field to look into. An environmental engineer's median salary is around $67,000 per year, with most jobs requiring at least a bachelor's degree. This field is also very healthy, with an 8% predicted growth rate by the year 2030.
Software engineering career duties involve designing computer programs, quality checks to identify any issues with these said programs, and working with other scientists to solve environmental problems. These careers often require a strong background in mathematics. These careers are typically office jobs and most often require working on a team with other software engineers. There is some overlap with both environmental and remote sensing fields. Median pay for software engineers is $110,000 per year. Typical entry-level jobs require a bachelor's degree, and careers in this field are projected to grow 22% by 2030, which is above average.
Geotechnical scientists research and study soil to evaluate its suitability for foundations. They investigate and assess construction sites, conduct lab tests, create designs for structures, supervise construction, write and present reports. They work on projects such as designing tunnels, roadways, retaining walls, and earthen dams, as well as help to create strategies for the cleanup and management of contaminated sites. This field is experiencing job growth of 7%, and the mean pay of these jobs is $75,000.
Careers in engineering most often have overlap with the environmental and remote sensing fields, but may have overlap in others. The engineering field is diverse and a great option for those who enjoy teamwork and problem solving.
Remote sensing and GIS work has become a vital part of our everyday world and continues to become more so with the constant evolution of computer technology to boast it. Massive datasets can be analyzed in a fraction of the time, more detailed geographical and geological maps can be auto-generated with proper programming, and thousands of miles of terrain can be viewed in a day to find the perfect site conditions. Knowledge of commonly used code bases like Python and R, as well as the ability to navigate GIS software like ArcGIS Pro, will quickly set you in the running as a competitive candidate for many of these available jobs. Some common knowledge sets people in this field bring to the table include mathematics, statistics, computer science, and physical geography. Capable people in this field are invaluable to modern projects of all kinds.
A new career path that is really taking off is being a drone pilot. Drones excel at taking over jobs that are dark, dirty, and dangerous, like mapping underground sewage and electricity tunnels for a city. There are many other uses for drone technology, like identifying subsurface conditions for construction companies, oil and gas pipelines, and strip mining conditions. While there are no college paths to becoming a drone pilot, there are certification training and testing programs all over the country. Median pay is $60,000 per year, with a 20% compounded yearly growth rate until 2031. This data was culled and averaged from several job and career websites, as the profession is still young enough that the Bureau of Labor Statistics has not published any statistics on this career.
Remote sensing specialists serve as an important part of many large-scale operations due to their ability to view and analyze massive areas all over the world. This job can have many phases and expectations, but some common practices consist of the analysis of aerial and satellite imagery, along with LiDAR and sonar data to determine ground composition, characteristics, and cover. As for the sites themselves, they vary greatly, but can include those that are difficult or impossible to access, some even dangerous. One important aspect is that some of the data can be used for risk assessment of a project site against local obstacles and natural disasters. Remote sensing applications are not specific to any one sector, but rather can be helpful in one way or another to them all. While it's necessary to have boots on the ground for in-person observation, it's equally valuable to have people who can view the larger picture. Between the money invested in these projects and the scale of them, people with this job are often well paid, with an average salary over $80,000 per year. For education, most professionals in these positions have a bachelor's degree or higher. Although slightly lower than some others on our list, this field is still growing, with an expectation of around 4% by the year 2030.
Environmental data analysts tend to focus in statistics, working with market research, environmental data, and other business information to make it accessible to the general public. Environmental data can include climate, contaminants, natural hazards, and more. Students who enjoy working with numbers and technology will find careers in this field appealing. Typically, these scientists work in mostly office settings, with travel being necessary depending on the client. There is overlap with the environmental, natural resources, and engineering fields. Median pay for data analysts is $82,000 per year. Typical entry-level jobs require a bachelor's degree, and careers in this field are projected to grow 25% by 2030, which is above average.
If you enjoy combing over massive data sets, operating UAVs, designing maps, or writing code, then this branch should be high on your list. The growth for these jobs is often higher than average, and so is the pay, all while providing a comfortable office job at least some of the time.
We hope that these examples have inspired you to investigate the geosciences as a career. Having a degree in the geosciences shows critical thinking skills and motivation. And remember, all the statistics for pay grade and job growth came from the U.S. Bureau of Labor Statistics. Comment with any questions below, give us a like, and don't forget to rock that subscribe button.